Hi everyone. Today in this video we are going to discuss about Meclizine. What is this drug Meclizine? The suffix "gine" indicates this drug is a piperazine derivative. This drug blocks H1 receptors and it is classified as antihistamine. Just like the other antihistamines working centrally such as cinnarizine, cyclizine, this drug is again a piperazine derivative. And it is useful in the treatment of nausea and vomiting, any dizziness associated with disturbance in vestibular system, or in the treatment of vertigo where there is a reeling sensation because of dysfunctional vestibular system, and even in the treatment of motion sickness which is associated with nausea and vomiting. In all these conditions, this Meclizine can be used. This drug is available under the brand name Antivert. So today in this video we are going to discuss how this drug acts, what is the mechanism of action, side effects, precautions and doses we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of Meclizine. Now you can clearly observe the piperazine ring system. So we can write the suffix as piperazine. And let us give the numbering to the nitrogen. So this is the first nitrogen and is the fourth nitrogen. To the first nitrogen, a simple methyl group is attached. So we can write this as 1-methyl. This methyl group is attached with two phenyl rings. One of the phenyl ring is having chlorine group at the para position. So we can write this as 4-chlorophenyl. Similarly, we have another phenyl ring. Simply, it is a phenyl. So these are the groups attached at the first position of piperazine ring. Now at the fourth position, again another methyl group is present, so 4-methyl. But again this methyl group is attached with a substituted phenyl ring. So this is nothing but 3-methylphenyl. So that is a complete name of Meclizine. So Meclizine is a methyl piperazine derivative. Now let us see how this drug acts. The vomiting reflex is mainly controlled by one of the central nuclei vomiting center, which is getting the impulses from CTZ, chemoreceptor trigger zone, as well as NTS, nucleus tractor solitary. But the colon also play an important role in stimulation of nausea and vomiting. The toxic chemicals within the diet, they can act on the enterochromaffin cells so that they can release the mediators such as 5-HT. Now these mediators can enter into the circulatory system, where they can be transported into the CTZ so that they can induce a vomiting reflex. So the chemical signal is mainly detected by CTZ chemoreceptor trigger zone. Similarly, if you have the sensory neurons, can also send the signals to the NTS. These are the vagal afferent neurons which can send the signals to both NTS as well as CTZ. Based on the motility of colon, they can send the signals so that again they can increase the vomiting reflex. Now the NTS can send the signals to the vomiting center if you have the impulses coming from the CTZ, and even the higher centers of the brain such as cortex can also send the signals to the vomiting center. So vomiting center plays a key role in induction of nausea and vomiting. Now by all of these impulses, it results in the vomiting sensation which is associated with vertigo and motion sickness. Particularly at the motion sickness, NTS play an important role. And when there is more impulse are generated from NTS, a vomiting reflex can be observed during the motion. Now this NTS is expressed with H1 receptors, as well as vomiting center is again expressed with H1 receptors. These are the histamine receptors. Now Meclizine is one of the drug which acts as an antihistamine. This drug can block the H1 receptors expressed on NTS so that it can inhibit the activity of NTS. Similarly, it can also act on the H1 receptors on vomiting center so that it can inhibit the vomiting reflex. In this way, Meclizine acts as antihistamine which can reduce the vomiting reflex, as well as it can also reduce the symptoms associated with vertigo and motion sickness. What are the precautions? One of the important precautions of Meclizine is that this drug can act centrally and it can produce some drowsiness in the patients. So particularly, this Meclizine should be carefully given with other drugs as well as alcohol, because this alcohol can further increase the drowsiness in the patients. And even there should be caution for the patients who are driving the vehicles or the patients who are working with machinery, Some caution should be taken because this drug produces some significant drowsiness in the patients. Similarly, meclizine can produce some anticholinergic side effects. It can produce few of the conditions such as dry mouth, which is due to the block of muscarinic acetylcholine receptors at the salivary glands. Similarly, it can affect the eye and it can produce some pupillary dilatation as well as blurred vision. Both of these conditions can increase the intraocular pressure. So, this drug should be carefully given in the patients who are having the risk of glaucoma. So, in the patients with glaucoma, this drug can further increase the intraocular pressure. So, in such patients, this drug should be carefully given. Similarly, this drug can produce constipation as another anticholinergic side effect. And it can also affect the respiratory system, resulting in bronchoconstriction. This bronchoconstriction in the normal patients is not that much significant. But in the patients with asthma, this is more significant. So again, in the asthmatic patients, care should be taken when this meclizine is prescribed. Another anticholinergic side effect is on the bladder. This drug can produce some bladder relaxation, resulting in urinary retention. This is more important to the patients with any prostate enlargement. So care should be taken in the elders with any prostate enlargement. This drug should be carefully given. What are the side effects? The important side effects mainly include dry mouth, drowsiness, some headache, fatigue, and blurred vision because of anticholinergic side effects. Some anaphylactic reactions such as nausea, skin rashes, dyspnea, difficulty in breathing can also be observed with this meclizine. How it is given? This drug is available as tablet at 3 strengths. It is available as 12.5 mg, 25 mg, 50 mg. It is also available as chewing tablets at a strength of 25 mg. The dose of the drug is variable from 25 to 100 mg given per day. It can be given as divided doses. So based on the control of nausea and vomiting and other symptoms associated with motion sickness, the dose is variable from 25 to 100 mg. So that's about this drug meclizine. Meclizine is a methyl piperazine derivative and it acts as antihistamine. This drug is used in the treatment of nausea and vomiting, dizziness, vertigo that are associated with disturbance in the vestibular system. And it can also be used in the management of symptoms associated with motion sickness. Drowsiness and anticholinergic side effects are the important side effects that are produced by this drug. And this drug should be carefully given in asthmatic patients or patients with prostate enlargement or patients having a prehistory of glaucoma. In all these patients, this drug should be carefully given. And this drug is available as tablet as well as chewable tablet. The dose of the drug is variable from 25 to 100 mg. 25 is the initial dose and 100 mg is the maximum dose, which can be given as divided doses. So that's about this drug meclizine. That's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.